there's been a lot of talk about the bikini shot, yeah.
I can't believe it, honestly. I just thought it was going to be a little bit in the back of Best magazine and all the national papers picked up on it and it ended up on the front page. I was, you know, quite shocked, actually, that anybody's interested. There's one good thing that comes with age, that you don't care as much. You know, I think women are always putting themselves down and worrying what other people think all the time. And I think as you get older, you just, I don't care. I'm going to do what I want for the rest of my life. I'm not going to be here for much longer.
No, but it's a good mantra, isn't it? And I think the less you care, and I don't mean to be horrible to other people because of that, but you do, that confidence sort of seeps in. And that, it obviously, it oozes from you, Linda. Like, you do, you're a confident, beautiful woman. And you think that is a lot to do with what's going on up in here.
I do, because we're our worst enemies. All women do, when they look in the mirror, is look at their faults. They don't look at the good things about themselves. Yeah. And, you know, I think you go out and you think, oh, I can't do that because this looks fat or that looks fat or my bingo wings or whatever. You, nobody cares. I think as you get older, you realise that nobody really cares. They're so involved in themselves. They're not worrying whether you've got a bit of cellulite or not.
No.
Just go out there and be you. Mm. Be the best you you can be.
Yeah, exactly. I could not agree more. Easier said than done sometimes.
We're looking at Lorraine today.
Well, yes. I mean, you were the original Page Three girl.
Well,
we know that.
But give me a
Lorraine has taken it over this morning on Page Three. Look at that, in her bikini on her holidays.
Well, isn't
just
that amazing?
Yesterday. Isn't it fantastic? Yeah. Well, and as you say, why not?
Why not? You know, you've only got one body and you're only here once.
Yeah.
Enjoy it.
It doesn't matter how old you are.
Absolutely.
Exactly right.
Stop worrying what other people think all the time.
But do you do anything to try and keep fit or to try and sort of just keep yourself, you know, within the areas that you know you feel happy with?
I had a 3-week holiday in Mexico and came back, you know, a good few pounds heavier. I just cut back, you know. I mean, the tricks I always do is I use a smaller dinner plate, drink lots and lots of water, try not to eat for 12 hours a day. And that sounds, what? 12 hours a day? But you go to bed, you're asleep for 8 hours, just do 2 hours either end. Don't have your breakfast till 11 in the morning. And if you go to bed at 10, then you've done your 12 hours. So give your body a chance to, you know, be completely clear of food for half the day.
That's interesting, yeah.
You know, when you go for a packet of biscuits, try and have a banana instead. I mean, I looked...
That's
you
the
know,
boring bit, though, isn't it?
I know, but, you know, you couldn't possibly eat 1,000 calories of bananas, but you can easily eat 1,000 calories of biscuit in 5 minutes.
Very true, very true. And moderation, isn't it?
Moderation,
it's the old moderation one. Yeah. What did your lovely daughter, Lucy, and indeed husband, Sam, think of the picture? And indeed the reaction to it, because here we are talking about it.
Well, actually, it was Lucy that took the picture.
Was it?
Yeah, because I have a photographic studio, so... I braved it in front of her.
We talk about you sort of shunning plastic surgery and everything else, Linda. Where do you stand on that? And you see so many, particularly young girls now, maybe early 20s, really starting at that point to change their faces. Like, how do you feel about that?
I think it's up to the individual, and I'll never say never, but I do worry for the sort of... I mean, girls under 20 are having 18, 19, having lip fillers and things. You know, what's going to happen to them when they're my age or your age, mm-hmm. you know, when it's not fashionable to have those pumped up lips anymore because you're stretching that skin. They're going to end up with tram lines and baggy skin on their face. And at 18 to 25, you're at your prime. You don't need any intervention from plastic surgery or Botox or fillers. You should just leave yourselves alone. You're naturally beautiful at that age anyway.
Yeah. I mean, it's a different place nowadays to what it was when you first started out in this sort of business, isn't it? I mean, do you feel that there's more pressure on young people? And I don't know if you feel it with Lucy because she's a performer and is wanting to get into this whole music scene herself. Do you think there is more pressure on young people to look and feel a certain way?
I do feel they all want to look the same. Mm. I mean, I'm very lucky that Lucy doesn't feel like that. I mean, I think Lucy has a look of her own and she's embraced that look and she doesn't want to change it. But if she started to want lip filler, I would definitely, you know, sort of try and deter her from it because I don't think you should be messing with yourself that age. I mean, I think there's different kinds of plastic surgery. There's plastic surgery that people have to try and remain looking young. But the plastic surgery these girls are having is to change the way that they look.
Mm.
And I don't think it's healthy.
Yeah, not always, of course. What is next now, Linda? Has this opened the doorway again, do we think? Shall we be seeing Linda in different various poses?
Oh, I don't think so. No, I think think you should see me more with my clothes on than off.
Not at all.
No, oh, no, absolutely not. No, I mean, that was just a one-off, and I can't believe how much it blew up and the reaction that it got. I mean, it's very, very flattering.
Yeah.
But I won't be doing that regularly.
Well, we've all very much enjoyed it. You look fantastic. And like you say, Lucy took it. So it was a nice controlled environment.
Oh,
it all felt very, you know, easy, didn't
it?
You have to hook through that attic a little bit more and see what else you can find.
Well, I've probably got everything I ever had in the 80s. Honestly, I'm such a hoarder.
Oh, I love that. That's brilliant. Well, thanks so much, Linda.
Oh, lovely to see you.
Great to see you. And send my love to the whole family now because they're all great. Thank you very much.